What's up everyone, it's Mark aka The Druid here, and as promised I'm happy to share a new quick tutorial about how to create this cool magic trail for your videos, motion graphics and anything you like. As for the previous tutorial about how to create an amazing rock, this one is not exactly recommended for very beginners, but it would require at least a basic knowledge of the Blender interface and its standard commands and shortcuts. I did my best to make it as quick and simple as possible. You know, I'm trying myself to learn little by little in order to be able to share the best content I can within the channel for the future. I'd be super happy to get your critics, comments and feedbacks in the comments down below. That will surely help me to improve. That being said, thanks again for being here with me and enjoy the tutorial.
Okay, so here we go again with Blender and its default cube. Let's shrink it. Man, this word is so hard. Let's shrink it down until it disappears. In my case, I needed a video reference in order to set the right path for my particles. So I used Shift A to create an image from plane with a video of me doing the weirdest kind of Tai Chi ever. Then I created a plane as the emitter for my particles, since I was thinking about something that could resemble the shape of my hand. You'll see I'll change the emitter with a sphere soon enough. So I started creating the path for my emitter by activating the auto keying, which is very handy in this case, and proceeded by following the movement of my hand. This way, every time I move within the timeline, a keyframe gets automatically recorded whenever there's a change in the object involved. Time to set the particle system already. As for default settings, you get Halo for particles with Brownian physics that, as you can see, are not exactly what I need, as they just fall down like a cascade. So change the physics type to voids in order to obtain some fluffier magical floating effect. Now we need to create our very own particles to replace those halos, and since we'll probably need loads of them, cube will just be fine because of the low polycount involved. Plus they'll be so tiny that no one will notice they are actually cubes. Let's create a material for them. The only thing we actually need in this case is the emission color and strength. In fact, I should have simply used an emission shader instead of the default principle BSDF, but never mind. You can use whatever shader node you like, depending on the appearance you want for your particles trail. Right, don't forget you need to activate bloom with EV settings in order to see the glooming effect on your particles. So change the render from halo to object and select your tiny glowy cube. Get ready to test your new particles and... You'll probably need to adjust its scale from the settings immediately after, until you find the size you like. Test it out by jumping to the beginning of the timeline so that the cache gets reset. Here you'll see I play a bit with some settings to change the number and the weight of the particles, and keep testing the effects by playing the timeline back and forth. This is basically the majority of the process while creating particles with Blender. In my case, with a bit more random actions than usual. Okay, somebody needs to stop me now. I finally realized a sphere could be a better emitter for my particles trail, so here it comes. And I don't even need to reset all the keyframes, as I can simply add a copy transform constraint so that my sphere replicates the movements of my plane. What we need here is definitely more particles. Oh, we're getting there, I can feel it. Just need a bit more variety with those cutie glowy cubes and rename those objects just to keep the outliner slightly tidier than before. Once again, change the render type in collection and select the one that has just been created. That's it, really. You can get simple yet cool trails like this, without too much fuss. Obviously, the more you play with the settings, the more you understand how you can customize every single detail of the effect, like the forces I'm showing here. Brownian adds some random craziness to the movement of your particles, whereas damp makes them more like sticking to each other, creating interesting effects. And there's even more settings available for voids, like relations, which I won't treat in this quick tutorial, as I want to make it as simple as possible. Also, remember to set the lifetime of your particles and you're good to go. I hope you enjoyed this simple tutorial and also had some fun by following it through my channel. I know there are lots of channels with Blender tutorials out there, so I really appreciate you stopping by to view mine. So, thanks! From yours truly, The Druid, and I'll see you the next time. Bye!